right? So I don't know where the politicization.
No, I have a feeling that in the Park Street episode, can I just have a line? In the Park Street episode, I think she was misinformed by the police. That's what we've been told. Initially, for an initial reaction, she was misinformed.
Ashok,
that is what
she's the chief minister. She's the chief minister. If she can storm a police station to release some workers who she felt were wrongly detained, she can also go into the police station and release the assistant professor for protesting against slum eviction. That's the point. Sohail's intervening tonight. Yes, Sohail.
Arnab, I have a couple of things to say. Number one, the tragedy is that Mamata Banerjee has not grown out of the role of the leader of opposition. She's still the leader of opposition despite being the chief minister. Someone needs to tell her that, ma'am, you're no longer the leader of the opposition. You are the chief minister, responsible not for TMC, but for West Bengal, which is a state in the Union of India. A. B. I refuse to accept that it is the police which mishandled this without either the benevolence or the silent nod from the political party, as it were. Number three, remember one thing. West Bengal has always had organized cadres, either for voting or for violence. They practice the two V's with great efficiency. If you unleash the cadres, then obviously the cadres are doing things that have your approval, or you're silently condoning them. So here's what I would suggest. It's no point being absent on Times Now or other news channels.
And
Mamata Banerjee should stand up and say...
No, not absent on other channels. I'd like to point this out, Sohail. 1 minute. TMC representatives are not absent on other channels. In fact, you'll find them on other channels discussing other issues.
Well,
my question is, why would you not be open to discussing this issue? Why would you not be open to this?
But you must go and carry a bunch of roses to Mamata Banerjee the next time you go to Calcutta.
Well, that's
if you won't be arrested at the airport itself.
My question
is... But having said that, I think there are two or three huge problems today. Bengal, for the last 8 or 9 months, has been in the news for the wrong reasons, which it shouldn't have been. Number two, there are some decisive law and order steps that Mamata Banerjee has taken. Give her her due. But the problem is, the deafening sound of her misdemeanors is so huge that the good often gets obliterated. And that's my worry. In the process, Mamata Banerjee is not being harmed. Please, let's not fool ourselves on national television to say that this is an indictment of Mamata Banerjee. It is a degradation of West Bengal, which was at the forefront of liberal thought, at the forefront of free speech, and at the forefront of diversity.
Ashok.
That's the harm and the damage we're doing to West Bengal. That's my worry.
Ashok.
I'm not bothered about what damage has been caused to Mamata Banerjee's image.
To Ashok and Sunanda Sanyal, my question is, you know, obviously Mamata Banerjee believes that all this, all the people who are upset about scientists being arrested, people who forward cartoons being arrested, beaten up, you know, all the other, these people don't matter. Is this a post-election result high? Will it last? And does it really not matter? Ashok.
I find a strange parallel with the incident involving Dr. Vinayak Sen, who himself has commented on this episode, which I read in several papers today, and his unlawful detention. In fact, we all protested against that. And also the unlawful detention of Zafar Panahi in Iran, which the government of India didn't take any steps against because they had to maintain diplomatic relations with Iran for necessitating the fact that their presence in the United Nations. Now, what I'm saying is that obviously this violation of democratic space is something which we do not condone. Nobody can possibly condone it. I don't know. I mean, I'm not aware that Mamata Banerjee takes all these decisions on her own. You spoke about her painting the town not red but blue. But I feel that some overzealous sycophants have been doing that, trying to outdo her. And that may have happened also in the case of the police. But it is now time for her to act.
I'm not analyzing her core team. I'm not talking about whether she's been misled. She's the chief minister.
She
is the chief minister.
And obviously, to allow
democracy
to take its course.
She is the chief minister. She is the person who's ultimately responsible. There is a professor. There is a professor who has accused four people of beating him over a cartoon to declare he's a member of another political party. He has been charged under section 506, 321, 341 and 114. Now, what is the justice there? Would you blame the police for that? if the police so is being no over-eager, what is Mamata Banerjee done to say no?
Film by Ray, Satyajit Ray, which it was a kind of a humorous, distortion.
It's a joke.
It's just a joke.
Mr. Sanya.
That, actually, you see, he passed around these coats, and therefore he was booked, and he was supposed to be, the police station could grant him bail, and even then he was almost 16 hours he lapsed in jail. This is not good. On the other hand, the other people, the Trinamool people, were released on bail. This is not true. This can't happen.
No, Mr. Sanyal, Ms. Mamata Banerjee obviously feels that all this criticism does not matter, that it does not amount to anything.
It does matter. You're making a mistake. It does matter, Arnob. She is exactly behaving like George W. Bush behaved. Either you're with me or against
me. Where's the rule of law?
That someone needs to tell her. Yeah, this is something someone needs to tell her that she shouldn't be doing. It's bad for her. It's bad for Bengal. Number one. Number two, we have a pernicious environment in Bengal
it's
today.
It's really bad
really
for Bengal.
For the great
no
people
doubt about
of
it.
You know, the tragedy, Arnob, is she has come to a state.
We don't know whether we are great or not, but it's really bad for Bengal.
But Arnob,
the reality is as follows. For years, she believes she is the target of elite media. For years, she believes that she's the target because she comes from humble beginnings. This is a belief and she's entitled to it. But now, as Chief Minister, it is her office that must dictate the manner of behavior. And that, to my mind, is not happening to the fullest as it should. And this is where people who are her advisors, who are in her coterie, must prevail. They must tell her that, look, you're not here running a political party. You're here running a state. You need administration and not opposition.
Mm. Well, you know, Ashok, I don't know how long this is going to last this way. Do you see even her closest supporters, even those who are being described as a coterie, you know, having to rethink their positions? Can somebody in the Trinamool Congress go to Mamata Banerjee and say, Madam, I think you're wrong on this? I think the positions you have taken are incorrect.
I think they can.
Is there that kind of democracy within the TMC?
No. Chief advisor on education.
No.
He's very eminent. And even if he has resigned, he at least has an opinion which is valued by the chief minister. Otherwise, he wouldn't have been, you know, the entire overhauling of the education system has been done by him. He is the right person to voice his opinion.
I don't believe at all.
And he's doing it. So
I don't believe at all that the chief minister cares for my advice.
No, would you go to the chief minister? Would you go to the chief minister and give her your frank opinion?
No, I won't.
He may be arrested on the way.
I won't.
Why? If you don't.
If she calls me, well, I might go, but otherwise, I can't. You see, I don't want to be abused.
Anticipatory bail.
Well, you know,
please
I...
Please take anticipatory bail. But I think, Arnob, on a serious note, it is indeed sad that for a political leader like her, who actually came from humble beginnings, struggled against the communists, and that was a repressive regime as well, for her to suddenly decline in stature and slide in terms of media attention and media focus is indeed sad. What I'm appalled by is that is no one giving her proper advice?
Absolutely.
Or has she completely blinkered herself to the outside world? Because this is not the world that she's going to inherit or, for that matter, change.
Absolutely.
It's bad for Bengal.
Well, and if you think that there should be Trinamool Congress representation here on Times Now, do write into them and tell them to do participate. At the end of the day, Kolkata has been known for debate, Kolkata has been known for dialectic, Kolkata has been known for differences of opinion, out of which there is intellectual curiosity and openness of mind, and new ideas have emerged out of that. To make sure that that is not allowed to really exist, is tragic. We'll follow the story. It's not just Noam Chomsky, but perhaps a lot of people here in India who have points of view on this as well. Following the story, hoping we have a TMC representative next time. Gentlemen, thank you very much. Thank you very much for joining me on the News Hour.
Can I just make one line?
Okay, one word from Ashok.
One line.
Yes,
you know, I'm just reminded on a non-serious note, and I think Suhail will appreciate, there was this old Russian story of a man who was walking down the streets of Moscow and he saw another man and he said, "What are you thinking?" And the other man said, "The same as you're thinking." So the first man said, "Then it's my duty to arrest you."
I might chip in at this point.
Arnab, do me a favor. Send her a bunch of flowers tomorrow.
I just
and
want
she
to
melt.
Say.
Yes, Mr. Sajjal.
I just want to say that we wanted the CPIM removed because it was getting anti-people. But we didn't hope for democracy to be set up within a short time. But unfortunately, within 10 months, the trends are clear, and which are very, very bad.
Well, it's very worrying when someone like you and of your experience, eminence and political position also says that. Well, the gravity of what Mr. Sanyal says is not lost, and even in the levity of what Sohail and Ashok say, the true meaning of the argument they're making is also not lost on all of us. But thank you, gentlemen, for joining me. Thank you very much indeed.